Welcome to the Gospel Quartet Paradise Midweek Oldies Show on Soul Prosper Radio. I'm Elder Lee Williams, and for the next hour, we'll present music from yesteryear by some of your favorite quartets. We invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Without any further ado, let's fire up the old turntables.
Too many years. I've laid awake at night, and I've shed the crossroad in my life. Standing there just wondering which way should I turn? See, like every time I turn to my right side, I find trouble, confusion, misunderstanding. And then I turn to my left side, find out somebody's sick, somebody's in the hospital, somebody done passed and gone on. And every time I look, I see healed.
Bye.
You're listening to the Gospel Quartet Paradise on Soul Prosper Radio with your host, Elder Lee Williams, where we play the finest in gospel quartet flashbacks.
We swear to die.
You're tuned in to the Gospel Quartet Paradise Midweek Oldies Show right here on Soul Prosper Radio with your host, Elder Lee Williams.
Say amen. Say amen again. How many have been touched by the hands of Jesus? Have God been good to you? Talking to the Christians that don't mind being a witness for me. You see, I don't care who you are, where you come from. If the Lord ever laid his hands on you, you never will forget that day. Could I get a witness? Somebody touch me.
Can I say it again? It's not enough to go to church on Sunday morning.
It's not enough
to go around crying, weeping and moaning. You gotta give
your life,
totally to Christ.
Only then will you know that Jesus is enough. It's not enough
to go down on your knees and pray.
It's not enough.
Then get up, talk about others any kind of a way. You gotta give
your life,
totally to Christ.
Only then will you know that Jesus is enough.
Let me say this. He's more than that. That run from woman to man. On God's land we can always stand. And when problems in our life they get real tough, then you will find Jesus is enough.
It's not enough
to say I'm a Christian and don't act the same.
It's not enough.
Though when you're rot, y'all know what I'm talking about, and hide in your hand, you gotta
give
your life.
Your life
totally to Christ.
Only then will you know that Jesus is in.
Let me say that verse again. You know what? He's more than that love that goes from woman to man. On my God's love, y'all know what? You can always stand. And when problem in your life, sometimes they get real tough, then you will find Jesus is enough. You know what?
It's enough
to just say I'm a Christian and don't act the same.
It's enough.
You're just throwing your rock, hiding your hand. But you know what? You gotta
give
your life, totally to Christ.
Only then will you know that Jesus is enough.
Only
then will you know. Jesus is enough.
Only
then will you know that Jesus is enough.
You gotta learn how to love your fellow man.
Will you know
if you wanna know
that Jesus is enough?
Learn how to do enough as you had him to do unto you. If you wanna know
Jesus.
Only
then will you know that Jesus is enough.
Only
then
will you know
that Jesus is enough.
You're taking a trip back down memory lane with the Gospel Quartet Paradise Midweek Oldies Show, right here on Soul Prosper Radio with your host, Elder Lee Williams. Don't touch that dial.
Grandmother was the mother of the church, and I was the oldest grandchild. Many days I would go by her home to talk to her. She taught me a lot. And some days when I would get to that old wooden house, tears would be running down those wrinkled cheeks. By me being the oldest boy, I always thought I could help. I used to ask, I said, why are you crying? She would look at me and say, son, you're too young now. You're too young to understand my tears. She said, but just keep on living. And friends, today, I can understand her tears. I'm not ashamed to tell the world. Sometimes I have to cry. And some days when I would get to that old house, she would be humming and moaning on songs, and sometimes she wouldn't come out and say the words, and I would say to her, why are you moaning like this? She would say, son, when I moan, it confuses everybody. It confuses the devil. He doesn't know what I'm moaning about. Now, I may not be able to moan like a lot of people, but I believe I can moan a little bit like my grandmother. If she was still with us today, she would sound something like this. In my mind, I can hear her sometimes working and washing and ironing in that old wooden house. Seemed like when she would moan, it would make the work easier. And in my mind, friends, sometimes when I'm riding along in the bus or flying through the air, I can hear her humming sometime like this. Listen. You know, and when he came home, he would always sing it. Listen, this is how it would go. Oh, yes. Sometimes I like to be in company, but don't you enjoy being alone sometimes? And he would say, and sometimes I enjoy just being all alone. But listen, he would say, when I go to my friend for just a little consolation. But don't your friends have problems too? He would say, most of the time you find them, and you know they are complaining too. But let me sing the chorus.
Today we'll hear some words from Elder Lee regarding anger management. There once was a little boy who had a bad temper. His father gave him a bag of nails and told him that every time he lost his temper, he must hammer a nail into the fence. The first day, the boy had driven 37 nails into the fence. Over the next few weeks, as he learned to control his anger, the number of nails hammered daily dwindled. He discovered that it was easier to hold his temper than it was to drive those nails into the fence. Finally, the day came when the boy didn't lose his temper at all. He told his father about it, and the father suggested that the boy now pull out one nail for each day that he was able to hold his temper. The days passed, and the young boy was finally able to tell his father that all the nails were gone. The father took his son by the hand and led him to the fence. He said, "You've done very well, my son, but look at the holes in the fence. The fence will never be the same. When you say things in anger, they leave a scar just like this one. You can put a knife into a man and draw it out. It won't matter how many times you do it and how many times you say I'm sorry, but the wounds will still be there." The little boy then understood what his father was saying to him. He looked up and said, "I hope you can forgive me, father, for all the holes I've put in you." "Of course I can," said the father. Train up a child while they're young, and the lesson won't go unheard. Let's go to Ecclesiastes 7:9. "Be not hasty in thy spirit to be angry, for anger resteth in the bosom of fools." This father taught by example. Control your anger and bridle your tongue. Elderly out.
Time is right now. And the sun's going down. Time is now.
The time is now.
Get in a hurry.
Get in a hurry.
And do it now.
Now.
I got one more thing.
Come on, children.
Come on, children.
Let's serve him today.
We need to go back. It's getting late.
It's late in the evening.
And the sun is sinking low.
Down.
Time is now.
The time is now.
Get in a hurry.
Get in a hurry.
And do it now. Listen, y'all. Every time you pick up your telephone, somebody close to you and go on, on. That lets me know. And the sun is going
down.
Down.
Time is now.
Get in a hurry. And do it now. There's one more thing, y'all. We've got to
stop using your
friends for stepping stone. Stop building walls of hate,
building walls of hate.
Around your neighbor's
around
home.
Your neighbor's home.
It's done got too late.
It's late in the evening.
And the sun's
sun
going down.
Down.
Time is now.
The time is now.
Get in a hurry. To get together.
It's late in the evening.
Have a little church.
It's late in the evening.
Reach out for someone.
It's late in the evening.
Show a little more love.
It's late in the evening.
The sun got so late.
It's late in the evening.
If you know you done wrong,
it's
in your life,
in
you ought to go down and knee.
It's late in the evening.
So please forgive me.
It's
forgive me, Lord. I want you to search my heart. If you find anything, Lord, you find a thing like sin.
You
find anything, Father, anything like hate.
It's
I want you to move in.
It's
yeah, I want you to move.
Did you know that you can hear broadcasts that you may have missed, or shows that you'd like to hear again? All you have to do is mosey on over to YouTube, where you can find many of our oldies broadcasts archived. We also have our new music broadcast featured there as well. All you have to do is go to YouTube and type in the Gospel Quartet Paradise. Enjoy. And to submit requests or comment on the show, just email us at elder.leewilliams@gospelquartetparadise.com. Stay blessed and not stressed.
Together. So quickly. I hope you enjoyed the broadcast today. If God says the same, I'll see you here again next week. Until then, stay blessed and not stressed.